हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर फाइन। एज वी ऑलरेडी नो ए लॉट अबाउट नंबर सिस्टम एंड वी हैव कॉम्प्लीटेड एक्सरसाइज 1.1। टूडे वी विल स्टार्ट एक्सरसाइज 1.2। नाउ Let's start exercise 1.2. In question number 1, three statements are given. First one, if the Iterson number is a real number, this statement is true. But why? We know that rational and irrational number are known as real number. You can write the reason here. Question number 2. Every point on the number line is of the form under root m, where m is natural number. This statement is false. But why? No negative number can be the square root of any natural number. Question number 3. Every real number is an irrational number. This statement is also false. You also can write the reason here. We know that rational and irrational number are known as real number. Now question number 2, are the square root of all positive integers irrational? If not, give an example of the square root of number that is rational number. All are positive. Suppose positive integers, square root of positive integers, square root of positive 3, 3 is irrational number, 3 is a irrational number. But under root of 5 is also an irrational number. Square root of 9 equals to 3, so it is a rational number. And square root of 16 equals to 4 is also rational number. Now let's start exercise 1.3. Question number 1, 36 by 100, question number 1, there are many questions. Write the following in decimal form and say what kind of decimal expression each has. 36 by 100, 36 divided by 100, 0.0300 point given, and so put value of 0, take, that means value of 36 by 100 equals to 0.36. So 0.36, what kind of decimal? It is a terminating decimal. That means 0.36 is a terminating decimal. You can solve all remaining sums सेम मेथड. क्वेश्चन नंबर 6. 329 बाय 400. अगेन सेम मेथड विल आई कैन सॉल्व. फोर एट जे 32. सीली मिस्टेक ना. फोर एट अगेन. Convert 329 by 400. Convert into decimal form. We get 0.8225. So, what type of decimal? This is terminating decimal. So, 0.8225 is a terminating decimal. Okay. Now next question. Question number 2. Question number 2. Value of 1 by 7 given 0.142857 bar. Without division, find the value of 2 by 7, 3 by 7, 4 by 7, 5 by 7, 6 by 7. First, one question, 2 by 7 equals to 2 into 1 by 7. 2 into value of 1 by 7 already given 0.142857 bar. That means value of 2 by 7 equals to 0.285714. Now you can solve remaining sum in the same way. Question number 3. Express the following in the form P by Q, where P and Q are integers and Q not equal to 0. There are 3 questions. Question number 3. Question number 1. 0.6 bar. Question number 2, 0.47, 47 bar. Question number 3, 0.001 bar. There are 3 questions. 3 questions, what type of decimal? 3 questions are repeating decimal. Let's solve question number 1. 0.6 bar equals to 0.6666 bar, repeating decimal. Let x equals to 0.6 bar. So 0.6 bar equals to 0.6666. Question number, equation number 1. Multiply by both sides 10. That means multiply both sides by 10, we get 10x equals to 0.6666 bar into 10 equals to, put the decimal, that is 10, that means put the decimal after one place, that means 6.6666 per equation 2. One equation, then subtracting from 2 to 1, we get question equation number 1, 10x equals to 6.666 bar, equation 2, x equals to 0.666, we get 9x equals to 6, that means x equals to 6 by 9. Lowest term, convert lowest term, 2 by 3. That means x equals to 2 by 3. What is the value of x? Value of x equals to, you know that, x equals to 0.6 bar. Therefore, value of 0.6 bar equals to 2 by 3. This is the form of P by Q. Okay, that's all.